The main objective of the forehand topspin is to hit the ball using an implement, racket, and project it over an obstacle net in order to achieve the point as soon as possible or make it difficult for the opponent to return the ball advantage. This float, from the mechanical point of view, is defined by Donskoi as a physical phenomenon in which the velocity of the body reaches the final magnitude in a very short time interval, shock time. Initial phase of the topspin forehand, initial phase. When the player has analyzed the trajectory of the ball, he has to move his racket back but without getting ahead of the orientation of the shoulders. In order to give more amplitude to the movement, the player extends the elbow joint and separates it from the body. The tip of the racket will be directed downwards and is at the level of the waist. The biomechanical characteristics of Chinese players are based on anticipation in this initial phase performing this movement. Before the ball makes contact with the side of the table, reflection of the ball, the racket is held at an acute angle, closed, and the free arm, with the elbow joint slightly flexed, is raised to balance the body. At the same time that the player withdraws the racket, starting from the starting position, the player places his feet and performs a trunk rotation to the right or left in order to bring the orientation of the shoulders perpendicular to the baseline from the table and parallel to the trajectory of the ball. During this phase, the player accentuates the flexion of the knees and transfers the weight of the body on the right or left lower limb, which is positioned backwards and laterally. Moment that the ball begins its ascent, the table tennis player Chen Meng has already been performing the action of the executing upper limb, hand with racket, towards the direction of the blow. Here the variable of anticipating that difference is even more observed to the biomechanics of the Chinese system in this blow to the rest of the world. The arm travels in an oblique path from bottom to top and with maximum speed. At the moment of contact with the ball, the racket remains closed in order to touch it tangentially. The wrist can accentuate the speed of movement of the racket. The ball is grazed at the highest point of its trajectory. The free arm participates in the movement, balancing the body by moving back into the left or right. During the performance, the weight of the body passes on the lower limb that is forward. The trunk participates in the blow through a rotation movement to the left or right in order to bring the orientation of the shoulders almost parallel to the net. At the instant of contact or collision between the ball and the racket, the tangential velocity variable comes into play, which is the third differential element between Chinese biomechanics and the rest of the world. The tangential velocity is equal to the angular velocity of the system, subject racket by the radius upper member in established axis of rotation. Generally in the rest of the world, this variable is decreased and no emphasis is placed on increasing the radius distance from the axis of rotation and the racket and the degree of flexion at the level of the elbow joint between the arm and the forearm is less at 95 degrees. This results in several mechanical weaknesses that we will talk about in the next installment.